Let's talk about the phenomenon of sleep. Each day is 24 hours. In those 24 hours, you're recommended to sleep 7 to 9 hours. The average lifespan is 72.6 years worldwide. This equates to 211,992 hours of sleep in a lifetime. Okay, so let's get this straight. In order to meet health requirements, you have to sleep 211,922 hours. However, there is no handbook deciding when you have to go to sleep and when you have to wake up. Therefore, when you sleep is totally of your free will. The average human wakes up between 7:30 and 8 a.m. For me, that is going to change.
What on earth did I get myself into? I feel like these next 7 days are gonna be very, very challenging and long.
Teenagers, we are the disappointments of society.
Me.
Addicted to social media, obsessed with naughty websites, being moody, shallow, and void of any human emotion are our specialties. However, all of this gets ignored because of a funny thing called hormones. When I was 12 years old, I would wake up before the sunrise and go running. Suddenly, I turned 13 and I'd be going to sleep as the sunrise. Being the accountable person I was, I blamed it all on hormones. However, it was actually just sheer laziness. Why? Why do we do this? Why do we procrastinate sleep? We as a society lack purpose in getting up early. The key word being purpose. When trying to do anything difficult, there has to be clear reasoning and purpose as to why you were trying to do this practice. This is what happened to me the first 2 days of this challenge. There was no purpose. Getting up at 4 a.m. is hard enough, which was made exponentially worse by the fact I had no idea what to do with these 3 hours.
Okay, so the thing is, I've been awake for the last hour, but I don't really know what to do with this time. I've never gotten up this early. So in this hour, I haven't achieved anything.
The benefits of waking up early are clear. You get to start the day hours before other people, allowing you to have more time for whatever you please. However, these benefits are lost if you have no purpose. A lot of people see celebrities like Elon Musk waking up at 4 a.m. and as a result think waking up early correlates to success. This is not the case. There is no value of waking up at 4 a.m. just for the sake of it. If your work in the morning isn't productive, it will be a waste of your time and increasingly difficult to find purpose in getting up early.
In the first couple days, this challenge was just about doing something difficult and getting up at 4 a.m. for 7 days. But now I want to see if I actually get any benefit from waking up this early and whether or not I should keep doing this. I have to say getting up early is really starting to grow on me. It's about 4 p.m. and I'm really drowsy, but apart from that, I just feel like I have so much more free time during the day. As well as I feel so cool getting up hours before other people even open their eyes.
However, it all fell apart. Like every other time I've tried to get up early, life gets in the way. Tonight's my formal. Well, not my formal, someone else's formal. I'm just going. It's also my first time wearing a suit. These things are kind of overrated. I just never thought I'd be wearing a suit. Yeah.
Okay, so it's currently around 11:30. If I went to sleep right now, I'd get about 4.5 hours sleep. I think tomorrow's gonna be a very, very hard day.
The next day would be one of the most abysmal days I've had in a long time. I've never understood the harmful effects of sleep deprivation until now.
I've literally tried to film this about 6 times. So yeah, my interview is in 20 seconds. And I can just barely string 2 sentences together.
All I wanted to say was that I had a job interview. As you could imagine, it went splendidly. I struggled immensely the whole rest of that day. Honestly, I felt like I wasn't even functioning as a human being at times. My patience for anything and everything evaporated.
Today was really, really terrible. I didn't achieve anything or do anything productive because of some arbitrary challenge which requires me to get up at 4 a.m. I would have been so much better off today having 2 or 3 more hours of sleep.
That night was the first time I felt enticed to break the challenge and not set my alarm for 4 a.m. However, when making new habits, it's crucial to remember the why. Why are you trying to build this new practice? There's this old quote that goes something along the lines of, "What you are doing is not nearly as important as why you are doing it." If you have a strong why, the obstacles that attempt to get in your way will be merely attempts. Why was I doing it? I wanted to determine whether I could be more productive if I started my day earlier, as I feel the hours spent at night are wasted on mundane activities. That was my why. The act of getting up at 4 a.m. is useless without knowing your why.
It's now day 7 and I'm not really that disappointed. I've had to get up at 4 a.m. for the past 7 days. However, one thing I have enjoyed about this challenge is the mornings. The mornings are really, really peaceful. Unlike any other point in the day, there are very few people around, which is nice. Wait, that just made me sound like I hated people. So it turns out waking up at 4 a.m. for 7 days did change my life. It just happened to be so in a negative way. Having completed this challenge, strangely enough, I will not continue to consistently wake up at 4 a.m. However, I'm still glad I completed this absurd challenge. I've always wondered whether I could get more done if I woke up earlier. For me, the answer is no. I have my answer. So cliche enough, you should go and get your answer. But keep in mind that there has to be reasoning and purpose as to why you're getting up this early, or else it is just getting up at 4 a.m. for the sake of it. Nailed it, killed it.